For Swiss standards, the Otemma glacier is pretty wild and hard to access. Getting there requires taking a narrow and winding tunnel to a point high above the Lac de Mauvoisin, where the road then switchbacks along a series of vertiginous cliffs towards the heights of the Val de Bagne, ending in a dark gorge. It is there where we leave our car and proceed on foot.
We have come here to make measurements over the Otemma glacier using a new drone-based ground-penetrating radar system that we have developed at the University of Lausanne. The objective of our field campaign is to acquire high-density radar measurements over a large portion of the glacier tongue. A camp organized together with other groups in the Faculty of Geoscience and Environment has been set up close to the glacier, 2 kilometers from our parking spot. With the equipment on our backs, it is our destination.
The camp is located on a grassy knoll overlooking the Durant river, which is fed directly by the meltwater of the Otemma glacier. Each of us has an individual tent to sleep in, which is spacious and comfortable. A larger equipment tent is used to store our material, as well as to examine the acquired data in the evening. The kitchen tent is a hub of high-end astronomy and card games late into the night. Finally, a fridge tent and dry toilets are also available.
The Otemma floodplain is stunning. From the glacier tongue, the river splits into numerous small channels whose arrangement changes dynamically along the day. We cross the river early morning to avoid strong and dangerous currents and are rewarded by the colors of the dawn light on the landscapes, made even more beautiful by the constantly evolving cloud coverage. After this obstacle, all that remains is to climb an unstable moraine in order to reach our study site on the glacier where, because of the anomalously high temperatures this summer, we regularly discover new structures, new crevasses.
Having arrived on site, we must first put together the radar system and plan the drone trajectories before recording any data. The instrument is programmed to fly back and forth across the glacier, roughly following the surface topography. The radar, in green and yellow, is attached beneath the drone. It transmits electromagnetic waves that propagate into the ice and are reflected toward the surface when meeting obstacles, which can be, for example, boulders, air cavities, water channel, or the bedrock interface. The radar antenna receives back these reflected electromagnetic waves and from the time of propagation between their emission and reception can be inferred the location of internal features into the ice body.
The parallel profiles multiply until the drone batteries have been exhausted, at which point we charge them on-site using a generator. In only 4 days, we were able to collect 462 profiles laterally spaced by 1 meter, for a total distance of 112 line kilometers of radar data with no risk nor physical effort. These 2D profiles can then be organized together to build a dense 3D model of the glacier. By looking at horizontal planes, called time slices, numerous reflections representing features within the ice can be observed. The bedrock interface, here rising on top of our image, is clearly visible, and a very precise map of the ice thickness distribution of the area can be made using this dataset. Furthermore, we expect to be able to track water channels within the ice, and that's why a deep analysis of these results might lead to new findings about the internal hydrology of the Otemma glacier.